it's time to blow this scene. Get everybody in the stuff together. Okay, 3, 2, 1, let's jam.
Hey. What's going on, Anoka? Last day of the week, weather's looking good. You've got Carmine and me rolling on the news. Best APs in the state. Who's got it better?
Something you should answer to this weekend is the request for senior photos and videos. We've been running this ad nonstop for the last month, and we're still a long way off from the amount of photos and videos that we need. So we're trying to get all the seniors to submit. Take some time this weekend. Get Maria your photos and videos.
Yeah, we gotta get a tough senior video, guys. Like, send in anything. Anything will do. She'll cut it up and make it look great. Also, take some time over the next week to get your fines, detentions, overdue library books, and other fines taken care of so you can go to prom this year. When they go on sale, prom is on the 26th and ticket sales start on the 17th. Man, bro, last year at prom, the lines getting our tickets were so unbearable. Like, I really hated that, bro.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, me too. Here's some other things that really make Anoka people mad.
What's going on, AHS? I'm Brennan.
I'm Vera.
And we are about to talk about things we really hate.
I hate when people chew loudly. If you chew loudly, please get out of my ear.
Get up out of the premises.
Wow, there's so many things. I don't even know where to begin.
When it's like a busy hallway and then there's like a slow walker in front of me, it really like bothers me. Like, can we keep the pace going?
Things I hate. People with hot breath and they know it and they want to be in your face. Like, have some courtesy, gang. Too much. Push off.
To be really honest with you, I could write a book. I could be here all day. I got it.
You got one more?
I don't got one more as of right now.
Oh my days. Oh, wet socks. Let's get dry socks, 2024. New premises. Hey, let's get it going.
Pajama pants. People who wear pajama pants outside of their house. You're not serious.
The pet peeve that I have is when people chew with their mouth open.
You're not a serious person. I can't take anything you say seriously.
Things that grind my gears. My coworkers.
One, liars for sure. Two, lazy people.
My biggest pet peeve is probably people who wear like band shirts but don't know anything about the band. Mm. And chewing with your mouth open, most definitely.
My pet peeve is people who don't know how to use utensils. People who bite down all the way on the fork and then you hear the grinding noise. I hate that. And also when they like rub the fork all over the plate and you hear the grinding noise, it's like nails on chalkboard. I hate it.
Pajama pants aren't the only thing that'll make people take you less serious. Seniors won't take you serious on the last day of the year if you don't have your senior t-shirt. There are a few left still, so get down to the Decamart and pick up one for you for $18 or one for a friend for $30. While you're down there, you can also check out the item of the week, the Anoka Windbreaker.
Have you got your shirt yet, bro?
I have not.
Me neither.
Two for 30?
Two for 30, hey! Also, tonight, there aren't any clubs taking place, but next Monday's a late start, and the Tornado Pals will be going on in the morning. Looking out a ways, Chess Club is looking to start back up. Their planning meeting will take place in M226 on Tuesday the 16th, so make sure you get up there if you're a chess player and want some local comp.
Shout out Jorik. Jorik? If you're listening, that's for you. And consider heading out to the store this weekend to pick up some activities, books, markers, puzzles, water bottles, or socks to donate to the Tornado Service Club and Chemo Drive. Most of you can find a couple of bucks to buy some games and puzzles for the kids getting through cancer treatment. Please show some support.
They need it, guys. Today's lunch is chicken bites, spicy chicken wrap, vegetarian salad for my boys. And now that you know what's going on for lunch, let's check in with sports.
Last night, the varsity boys tennis team put up the nets and served the ball into spring sports. Their home match against the Bengals officially started the season, and even though the team lost, Owen and Julian put together a strong win. Also taking the field last night were Anoka's ninth grade baseball teams and JV team, who traveled to Andover to swing it out against the Huskies. Both the ninth grade teams beat the Huskies, the 9A team winning 3-2 and the 9B team blowing out the competition. Spring sports weren't the only ones putting in the work last night. Anoka's theater program has been busy every day of the week as they rehearse for the spring musical Shrek. Here's some sights and sounds from their work last night.
We're building flats. How many are we building? About 14 of these. So a flat is these very, very large frames and they have like sheets of cloth on them and then they get put on a cube. I don't know.
What? A polydactyly. It's a projector before projectors were made, so it's a large cloth that gets painted over to where if we need a quick transition scene, we can just spin them to get to a new scene.
So a lot of wood glue, a lot of wood. And then there's these triangle bits. And then we're gonna put parts in between here and then we'll connect those with chisels, which are just little rectangles.
I just wanna say for the record that we are also building flats, but we are like 100 times cooler.
I guess I'd be a hero with sword and armor clashing, looking semi-dashing, a sword within my grip.
An ogre always stays in the dark.
You are alone.
Then you smile and gaze at me. Take my hand on bended knee. Bended knee. Bended knee.
Ow!
Sorry.
There's more action taking place tonight with the boys varsity tennis team heading down to the University of Minnesota's Baseline Center to take on Spring Lake Park. And then tomorrow morning, the girls lacrosse teams set up scrimmages against Osseo at 10. And the boys varsity track team buses over to the University of River Falls for their first meet of the season. Also happening this weekend, HOSA, Anoka's Club Future Health Professionals, heads to their state competition up in St. Cloud. We're going to end today's sports with more from them. That's all from me, covering for Jorick. Back to you guys in the newsroom.
I'm Addie Greeman, and I'm our Anoka HOSA's president.
I'm Addison Aldridge, and I'm the activities director of Anoka HOSA.
And we're here to talk about HOSA's State Leadership Conference, or SLC, that 13 of our HOSA members are going to be attending this Saturday, Monday, and Tuesday.
We've competed in various events, and we've also had the opportunity to go to the international competition last year in Texas. It's a really cool opportunity, and it's something you're definitely not going to get anywhere else.
Mm-hmm. Some of the events you can compete in are human growth and development, biotech, physical therapy, vet.
And what's really cool about it is it's not just a competition, it's a great learning opportunity. There's different like educational sessions, and you'll get to meet with highly trained professionals and use like thousands, million-dollar medical equipment that you wouldn't be able to use anywhere else. They have a lot of sponsors, and one of them was a company called Bio-Rad. They make a lot of stuff for bacteria, genetics, DNA, and I was actually able to precipitate my DNA, which basically kind of makes it show up in a white little clump, and then actually put it in a necklace and take it home with me. So that was pretty cool. I have done a fake cesarean, which is a C-section where your stomach gets cut open and that's how you deliver the baby. And it was kind of cool. They actually have a fake baby and a fake placenta, and then they put like grape seed oil, so it feels just kind of gross. And you reach in there and you actually like have to help birth the baby, and it's pretty cool.
Bro, this spring stuff is insane. Yeah. Last week, there was like 6 inches of snow, and now the courts and all the fields are completely clear, and the temps are reaching into the 60s. Change happens fast, and so do the weeks of trimester three. We're done with our first show and the third week of trimester, of the last trimester of our senior year, dude.
I know, it's going fast.
I'm Brennan.
And I'm Carmine. I'm about to go enjoy that weather.
Let's go.